Alright. Welcome to the first episode of the Delta Gaming Podcast. I'm your host, Brandon Luna, here joined by my good friend,
Will,
who is our new signee to the Delta Gaming.
Yeah, I just joined
roster. Actually, you've been in it for a month.
Well, to them, I just joined.
Yeah. It's a long story, just to say, the reason why we haven't been pumping out content is due to scheduling errors, and that's about it. It's just scheduling and a bit of, like, losing members, but you know what? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter, actually, so. But that's the reason why you haven't been seeing much content on here.
But now, since everything's going and we got some stuff going on.
Yeah, that's why we're starting a podcast, too. It's because I feel like I've always wanted to do a podcast because I've always been intrigued by podcasts and I always wanted to do one, and that's why I feel at Delta Gaming we have actually a chance to do it. Whoa, is that a new animation for the Battle Pack opening?
I don't know. I mean,
I think it is.
I haven't really played Battlefield 1 too much. I know it's really fun when I did play it, though.
Yeah.
It's a lot like Battlefront, you know?
Yeah, but it's better, but
actually, no. I take that back. Battlefront is a lot like Battlefield because that's kind of what they based it off of.
Yeah, but I think Battlefield's better than Battlefront, to be honest. But we all have our opinions. But yeah, there's a reason why. Also, for coming to Delta Gaming, I want to make a few announcements before we continue on with the podcast. We're going to be releasing a weekly show called Delta Gaming Omega. So we're basically basing this channel off of like WWE with like rosters, championship matches, and everything. And it's our version of Monday Night Raw, basically. So it's a weekly series every Wednesday. It's Wednesday Night Omega. And it's just going to be like promos, everything that we do here on Delta Gaming.
Yeah.
And then the last Saturday of every month will be a pay-per-view. Oh, look at that. I love the squad names for this game. Objective Butter and Objective Charlie. Apples.
Would you gonna play Assault Medic?
I'll play as Medical. What is going on?
Okay. That's,
this is weird.
Yes, let's find a new match because that was not supposed to happen.
Yeah, that's weird. And then Will will be doing live streams on the channel.
I will be live streaming every single Thursday. Every single Thursday.
You want it? All right, you gotta stick to that now.
I'm gonna stick to that every single Thursday.
All right.
First one's coming out tomorrow, since today is Wednesday. An operation mirrors the journey. And tomorrow probably isn't going to be Thursday.
So. Alright, I already know what operations are, lady. Alright, which one is my favorite? Alright, now, I never play on Oil of Empires because that one annoys, like, me really bad. I think I always play on Kaiserlacht. Or whatever it's called. Kaiserlacht. Kaiserslacht. Kaiserslacht. I'm sorry, if your family's German, well, I'm sorry.
We're not German.
Okay, then I did not
offend. We have German in us, but we're not, you know.
Okay.
And, but there are some people out there who are German.
Yeah, sorry if I offended you. Sorry if I offended you by...
Put a disclaimer.
Yeah. Yeah, that's basically it. And, oh, Jesus, we have to wake up. Oh, it'll be this Friday. Our first rehearsal for Basically Triple is this Friday, Will.
Nice.
I'm not going to be there. Because I'm going to Theater Fest for a show I do. Yeah, we're in high school, so I do theater. And I do theater, and we were recently selected to go down to the state where we go. We were selected to go down to state. And we're here when we're going to showcase our thing. Watch out for that vlog. I'm actually going to vlog that, weirdly enough. You guys want content? I want content on my channel, so I'm going to start vlogging.
Yep.
And, so that's basically it. Those are my big announcements. But yep,
now we're going to talk about,
whatever. Anything.
Whatever.
That's what a podcast is. Actually, since I want to stay on the topic of gaming, well, what... was the first ever game you've played? Like, first ever game you ever played? It's a basic question. I think we could all answer it.
I've watched other people play games when I was a kid. Like, my father always played, like, on the GameCube. That was the first system I ever really had and ever had to play.
What game did you... What was your first game you ever played?
The first game I ever played, though, is on the Wii. Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess.
Wow.
Yeah, it's one of my favorite games of all time.
Wow.
Because I always played through that game.
Didn't that game come out in, like, 2011, though?
No, like, 2006, actually.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
God, I'm old.
It was a console release. It came with the Wii.
Yeah, Jesus, I'm old. First ever game I played was Super Mario Bros. On the NES. So I'm 16, but my dad had the NES. He bought it at a garage sale, and he got it, and he still had it when I was with my dad, and yeah, he hooked it up one day, and he was like, "You want to play?" And I was like, "Sure." So the first game I ever played was Super Mario Bros. On the NES, not the SNES. But yeah, it's weird how a really old game actually was the first game I ever played.
Yeah, I mean, I played Twilight Princess when it was new, but you actually stuck to one of the originals, man.
Yeah,
Super Mario was known as, like, you know,
really old school.
Not that. I'm just saying he's like an icon.
He is. And for me to, like, get an introduction to Mario and, like, I mean, I didn't really like Mario at the time. I mean, I liked it, but, like, I wasn't like, I'm going to Mario up my room or anything, but I was really happy about it. And, yeah, so I'm really grateful that I get to stay with my objective brother squad.
And look, there's actually some gameplay this time.
Hold up. Let's actually see if we're... Okay, I'm going to change the gun on here. I do not like this.
I don't know if I... I haven't played this too much, so I don't have anything really good for you.
It's efficient for... What the fuck? Okay. Okay, is this the... Alright, I think... Oh, no, I play on Assault. Oh, my God. That's what
I thought you played on Medic.
No, I played on Assault. I just remembered. I play on Assault because I don't like... Medic for that reason. Alright, we have enough players. Why am I not spawn? Why am I not deploying?
Down A.
Round starts when enough players are ready. Oh my.
Other players aren't ready. Are you? Yeah, you know what? No, that gives us time to talk.
Alright, fine.
There are some games coming out this year. What are you excited for?
I really don't. I've stopped following a lot of, I really not informed that much on games when they're coming out. So, I don't know what games are coming out this year, but, the game I guess I'm excited for is, like, NBA 2K18 and WWE 2K18, because those games are always fun for me. NBA, especially with the My Career. It's always fun for me to play those. And then, yeah, that's about it. Just, here's the thing. I'm actually, like, really surprised how NBA was able to turn, like, into a normal sports game into, like, almost like a movie.
Oh, what are you talking about?
Like,
the My Career?
The My Career, yeah.
Oh, dude, no, like, I was not a big fan of basketball, and I played 2K16 My Career, and I don't know. Let me tell you, I cried. Like, I'm not even joking with you. Like, literally, when he died, when his friend died, I literally cried. Because I literally felt so bad for him. That was his best friend.
We're actors, so we really get... We're really emotional people.
Yeah, we look for the good in things, you know?
Yeah.
But, like, that actually made me sad. I'm not even joking with you.
It kind of did, too, for me. Because it was like... Like, you felt out for Vic, and, like, to see him die like that was, like, wow.
And, like, he wasn't even that major a character.
He kind of was, but he wasn't at the same time. So for, like, 2K to pull a George R.R. Martin on us kind of was, like, wow.
But, you know, you want to talk about emotional games. Last of Us, man. That game got me really, really bad. Like, have you played The Last of Us?
No, so do not spoil anything. Have you played The Walking Dead? Walking Dead, I think, is another one.
Telltale,
yeah.
Dude, no.
The first season.
Don't even get me started on that, dude.
I've seen PewDiePie play it, but, like, I didn't see the ending when he... Okay, I didn't watch PewDiePie. I watched a YouTuber by the name of CACox97 who did a bunch of, like, Nerf videos. I saw him play it. So I haven't found PewDiePie at the time, and, like, I always watched him play it. And this is before I even played it myself. I just watched him play it. But I cried. Like,
should we... I mean, if you haven't played it by now...
It's kind of on your fault, but basically...
No. Hold on, let's... Spoiler alert and skip past this part.
Yeah, skip to whatever number appears on the screen or whatever.
But basically, the ending when she had to shoot Lee because he was going to have a zombie, or if you pick the other ending, either way, it's really emotional.
It's really, yeah, because Lee Everett is the protagonist, the person you play as through the entire game.
It wasn't just that, it's just I felt really bad for Clementine.
Yeah, because... She's
just a little girl, you know, and she had to, like, shoot a, like, Lee was basically her father.
Father figure going through the zombie apocalypse because her father was bitten originally.
But the fact that she lost both her fathers, I mean, that's gotta mess her up. She was only a child.
She was, and that's why in season two.
Yeah, she did not trust anybody.
Season 2, I kind of... she doesn't trust anybody in Season 3, actually. Season 3, she's really...
Don't tell me anything. I'm planning on playing that soon, so...
I watch people play it.
I know she's, like, older, right?
She's 13.
And she was, like, 10.
She was 8 in the original game.
Okay, yeah.
She was 10 in Season 2.
Go up, get him!
I can't! The heck? I can't move. I think I'm out of... Alright, no, I'm just gonna mow him down. What? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? I got the first shot on him! Jesus fucking Christ. Okay.
Yeah. You know what? I'm glad games these days, they're more than just being fun or
there's stories.
Shooting people.
Yeah, it's...
Like, they legit feel like movies, you know?
I think that's what Call of Duty's been doing now. They're actually becoming more like interactive movies than just game. The campaign, I mean.
I don't know, man. Call of Duty is like... I mean, the original games were like that, but like now they're focusing too much on multiplayer.
They
like,
are.
Infinite Warfare, honestly, let's be honest, it's trash.
No, it's not. I'm actually kind of... I'm okay with it. I'm in the middle. I thought it was going to be bad, too.
I mean, I started playing the campaign, and it was actually fun. The campaign was fun, but multiplayer is not good. Just personally, okay? I mean, if you like it, that's cool, but...
Well, I was like you when I first saw it. I was like, oh, this game is going to be trash. It's not going to be good. Blah, blah, blah. And then I actually played the beta. I played the beta. I was still upset. I was like, what is this game? And then I got the game, and I was like, oh, this game is actually pretty... Hey, this game actually isn't that bad.
And then, like, Modern Warfare Remastered, though. That's good. Glad they enjoyed that. Definitely good sale. Definitely good for sales, because people totally bought that game when they found out Modern Warfare was going to be remastered.
They bought it just from... Okay, I'm going to tell you a thing. The only reason why people bought Infinite Warfare was for Modern Warfare Remastered. That's it.
And, hey, it's good. I mean, I just remember, like, when I played it originally, I was, like, playing as a sniper.
Mm-hmm.
Because that was, like, the first game where they introduced, like, quickscoping and stuff.
Okay. I'm going to say something right here, right now. Get it out of the way. I actually do not like Modern Warfare that much.
Okay.
It's...
I mean, I don't like Infinite Warfare, you know.
I mean, it's not really my favorite Modern Warfare. If you were to have me play a Modern Warfare game, I think I'd go with 2. Oh, almost drop shot in him.
And 3 was trash. 3 was totally
3 was okay. 3 was okay. It's not... But I think Modern Warfare 2 is the best one. out of all the Modern Warfares, and like,
yeah, it was pretty good, actually.
It was really good, but like, now if you were to go back and play it, which I think you should do, which I think would be funny, go back and play some Modern Warfare 2, I think that game is like hacked beyond belief with Viking. From what I've heard, I heard it's hacked beyond belief. Like, you cannot play a match in that game. That's what I heard.
Really?
Yeah, I heard you cannot play a match in that game.
Wait, it's for like Xbox? Or?
Like old, like all Modern Warfare 2.
Just for the like the entire for the that.
Like
that
multiplayer,
game.
Like multiplayer, you cannot play on because it's hacked.
When did that happen?
Like at Will, the game's been out forever, but people hack these games. Will.
No, but when did they hack Modern Warfare 2?
They started hacking it like. When everybody went to Modern Warfare 3, I believe. Like, when Modern Warfare 3 came out. Like, the older the games get, the more hacked they become. Like, if you were to go back and play Modern Warfare, like the first one on 360...
Yeah.
There's no way you can get a kill in. There's no way you can win a game.
Well, unless you become the hacker, you know?
But
who wants to do that, you know?
Yeah.
I want to actually play the games, dude. I don't like cheating.
Yeah, I don't like cheating either. It really takes the fun out of it.
I like glitches, though, where you, like...
Glitches are fun to a certain extent.
But when you, like physically change the codes in the game to get what you want, no. Like, if they have a glitch in there that you can do to mess around and have fun, then yeah. But, like, if you're actually, like, putting the glitches in there, it's not cool, man. It brings the enjoyment out of games. Because games, they were originally made for fun, and then now that they're like hacking them and stuff, you're pretty much, you know, lack of a better term, ruining them, you know?
Yeah, and back to your topic on how games were originally made for fun, I feel as if games are now also becoming competitive with the creation of esports. It's becoming more of a... Because I find it... I support esports. I actually like esports. Go team Envy. I'm Team Blue. I'm an envious fan. Team Blue. But... a lot of people don't think of gaming as a sport, actually. Believe it or not. Because it's like... When some people think of gaming, they think of like... Some fat teenager kid playing... on his couch, drinking Doritos, eating Doritos and drinking Mountain Dew.
There are actually plenty of, like, gamer chicks out there. Like, not even joking.
Oh my god, what?
I'm not even joking.
You're not kidding, but... Wow. With already gamer chicks, you're just going... there's gamer chicks out there, too. I mean, it's not just dudes.
Yeah, it's not just... That's, like...
Minitank!
Everyone thinks that...
Suck it.
Everyone thinks that they are, everyone thinks that when they think of a gamer, they think of a fat guy sitting on his couch, like you said.
Yeah.
But actually, a lot of gamers, they're girls.
We come in all shapes and sizes and genders.
I'm not gonna lie, they're kind of hot.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Hell, we have a few gamer chicks on Delta Gaming right now, right?
One at the moment.
Oh yeah, that's right.
One at the moment.
Alex.
But yeah, so one at the moment, but yeah, so but yeah, they're becoming competitive. They're reaching out to a wider audience nowadays. And also here's another thing about gaming. Is that what was I gonna say about esports, something blah blah blah. That's what I was gonna say. How people don't think of it as a sport because of that reason. And I almost find it kind of offensive to where you can think of somebody sitting down and, like, playing... you think of chess as a sport. Like, apparently chess is a sport, but you don't consider gaming a sport. Like, you're like, oh, gaming is not a sport. Oh, okay, but somebody moving a piece of plastic is a sport? Like, come on. Like, it really...
Or throwing a ball of leather. Which is a sport,
oh my
by the way.
God. I'm pretty sure you just made some of our audience mad with that. Oh, what? What?
Sniper man.
Jesus!
Isn't a football made of leather?
It's pigskin.
It's actually not pigskin. It's cowskin.
Okay. Oh, back then it was pigskin. Oh, Jesus Christ, then. But yeah.
Is
so,
it something made of leather in sports? I'm pretty sure, like, no. No. I like hockey, so.
Yeah.
Whatever. Continue what you were saying.
But yeah, it's just, I don't know why they don't consider it a sport, but it's on ESPN now. They're starting to broadcast it on ESPN now, so I'm really happy for that. I like, okay, here's the thing about Battlefield 1. I love playing with a gas mask on.
Why?
I don't know, it just looks cool.
I'm Kylo Ren.
I'm Kylo Ren. And then when I take off the mask, where's I'm the Kylo mask? Ren!
Where?
I'm telling on Snow. I'm sorry, I actually like Kylo Ren, but it's fun to poke fun at Kylo Ren. Yeah, you got the fair.
Where's the mark?
Here you got the fair kill.
I'm going to finish what you started. We are losing objective. I'm going to finish what you started.
Yeah, we're nerds here. Yeah, as you can tell, we're quoting Star Wars. When did you first start watching Star Wars?
Me?
Yeah, when did you?
I mean, I started watching it when I was really young. My parents introduced it to me right away. My dad's been a fan ever since the first movie.
Uh-huh.
And, well, he introduced me to it, and I was just like, this is amazing.
Yeah,
And so, yeah, I mean, like, I've been a fan of it ever since, and I've been collecting, like, the Black Series action figures recently. Uh-huh.
I'm seeing your room right now. You have, like, two Poe Damerons.
Yeah. One of them's in the flight suit. One of them's in his jacket.
Yeah.
From the beginning of the movie. So.
I was introduced to it, I think, not as young of an age as Will was, but I guess a young age, but...
I remember you said, like, 13, right?
No, I was in second grade, so I was about 7. I was 7 at the time. It's young, but not probably... What year... How old were you?
I was, like, 1 or 2.
Yeah, I was 7.
Before I could talk, I loved Star Wars. Before I understood what they were saying, I loved Star Wars.
Yeah. And I was 7. Like, my friends were just talking about it because they watched it. And I was like, what is that? They're like, you've never seen Star Wars? I'm like, no. Like, you gotta watch it, bro. So then I went to my library. I saw if they had any copies of Star Wars. And they did. And I grabbed some copies. And I started playing Star Wars. And it was really good.
You mean
watching Star Wars.
Battlefront? Yeah.
You're talking about Battlefront now?
Yeah, you said you were starting playing.
Not play, but I meant to say watch. But but yeah, I think the first one I ever saw was... I think it was... What was it? It was Empire Strikes Back. It was Empire Strikes Back, the first one I ever saw.
That's a good one.
That one is good. I saw Empire Strikes Back. That was the first one I've ever seen, and it really caught my attention.
That one's actually my favorite. Although, while I love A New Hope, Empire Strikes Back changed the game.
Yeah, it did. It's like, I don't know, like, how to describe how it changed the game.
Because it was new. Nobody expected another Star Wars to come.
Yeah.
Because when it originally came out, before it was called The New Hope or Episode 4, it was just called Star Wars.
Mm-hmm.
It was planning on being a one-movie deal because nobody thought it was going
to
do
good. Yeah, George... Okay, here's the thing. George Lucas actually went out to Hawaii opening weekend.
Yeah, because he was so afraid to hear what critics had to say.
And then when he got back, he was like... Everybody was talking about Star Wars, how good it was.
You know, he actually played it for all his director movie friends.
Uh-huh.
Like, he played it for Steven Spielberg and Richard mm-hmm. Donner and all them. He pretty much played it for them. And it was before it was, like, it was post-production.
Yeah.
They were still doing, like, the X-Wing sequences and all that.
Mm-hmm.
But he pretty much, before he put in X-Wings, he used World War II fighter planes and all kinds of stuff like that. And he showed it to them, and they all hated it. They said, this is gonna fail. But one person said that they liked it. was Steven Spielberg.
Yeah, I was just about to say, was it Spielberg? Because Spielberg
was like, this is going to be big.
Yeah.
And he was right. Because let's be honest, George Lucas, he's not that great of a writer. He got lucky with Star Wars, because if you've seen the prequels, he wrote them. And, you know, horrible, horrible dialogue.
I hate sand. Gets everywhere.
Gets everywhere.
You're from a sand planet, you piece of shit. You're a sand planet, you piece of shit. I hope you fucking know that.
I'll never join you! And stuff like that. Actually, that's from Empire, but yeah. Still, I mean, that's kind of cheesy. But nobody thought it was going to do well. Everyone thought it was going to fail. And, well, they were wrong, of course, because, you know, Star Wars is one of the biggest franchises ever.
So, how do I lock on in Battlefield 1?
Hold on, LT.
That was a joke.
Oh.
Because you can't lock on to in Battlefield 1.
Oh, that's right.
Since it's not fighter jets anymore.
Pretty sure that's your team's business. I haven't flown a plane on multiplayer yet.
I like flying planes. I like planes. They take me everywhere. Alright, ready for something freaking Okay. But yeah, I was going for something offensive there for everybody. And, there's...
Alright, so, do you have anything else?
I think we could go for 30. It's, only 4 more minutes left.
Alright.
We have 4 minutes. Yeah, sorry, we're doing, a really short podcast today because we're on a time crunch. Yeah, we're on a time crunch, and we just wanted to... This is, an introduction podcast. It's just to let you know what we're going to be doing with the podcast, what a podcast is.
And we gave you a little bit of an introduction.
We gave you a little bit of an introduction. And hopefully we can talk more about stuff. I think we're going to talk about one more quick topic right now. Which, I want to actually talk about... What is it? As I can look in your room, I see a bunch of Marvel stuff here.
Yeah.
I don't know, what are your thoughts on the current Marvel Universe? The MCU right now.
Well, I think Marvel Studios, which, you know, created the Avengers and Doctor Strange and all them, I think they're doing a fantastic job. Compared to
DCCU,
they're doing a marvelous job.
Like, they're slaughtering. Yeah. Oh my God, you fucking asshole! you asshole.
But, I loved Tom Holland as Spider-Man, even though we only got, five minutes of him.
Yeah, but this is the third Spider-Man, because the first one was Tobey Maguire.
Ew. He was okay. Andrew Garfield.
I did not like Andrew Garfield. I was like...
I thought the best thing about those Sony Spider-Mans was that, the web-swinging sequences were great. They seem real. I like the web swinging sequences.
You're kidding me. Okay, but yeah.
The web swinging sequences were great because mm-hmm.
He had
web shooters, not organic web shooter crap.
Unlike in Spider, the Tobey Maguire was organic, right?
Yeah, he had organic, and you know that's true to one Spider-Man, because I know Spider-Man Noir, you know him. He had organic web shooters.
Oh.
Or is it Spider-Man Noir? I think so.
I think so too. I'm not sure. I'll put on that because I don't want to die from mustard gas.
That was your teammate.
Yeah. Thank goodness we're not on hardcore because he would have died. But we're towards the end of our podcast here.
Yeah.
This is basically what you're going to be seeing a lot on for podcasts. I'm sorry if the quality for this video isn't as good because I don't have it set at 1080p and I don't want to stress the Elgato out that much. So this is what you're going to be seeing from us now until New Beginnings. New Beginnings will be coming out soon. I promise. I swear by that. It'll be coming out soon. And That's it. Well, do you have any last things you want to say before we go?
I'm really excited to be working with Delta Gaming. Definitely, because I'm excited to bring you guys a lot of content. That's pretty much it.
So
we should sign off.
Remember, stay tuned. What did you say when you're going to be releasing a live stream?
I'm going to start live streaming tomorrow, which is Thursday. By the time you'll probably be seeing this, it's probably not going to be Thursday. But peep that, because it is coming out tomorrow.
Alright, so that's basically it for today, guys. Thank you so much for staying tuned to listen to our podcast. And
really,
it
means a lot to us.
It does. And it really does. You guys don't know, but we like doing these things. We like just talking. And that's basically
even if it's not a big viewing audience, we just love to
help. We just like to throw stuff at you guys. Entertain. Anyways, we'll see you guys soon. Peace out.